Get ready to match the stars. From Ork and Mindy, Bob Donner. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reddy. Former Miss World, Marjorie Wallace. Bill Daly. And Marcia Wallace. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Rivers.
Howdy, howdy.
Hello.
All right?
Oh, golly, yes.
Golly, gee, yes.
If I were any happier, I'd blow my brains out.
We want to thank Miss Barbara Stanwyck for allowing Brett to wear some of the lovely things from the Big Valley television.
Actually, Laura Ashley, Madison Avenue.
All right.
Oh, New York City?
Yeah.
New York City.
New York,
yay!
New York.
Okay.
Let's say hello to Becky Einon and Ross Turncheck. I remember Becky. For those of you who are not here with us, Becky is 19 years old, and she does not know who Long John Silver was. She knows now, doesn't she? Yeah. What else you want to tell us about you?
I work in a bank, and yeah. I love to sing, and I love to ski. I sing all the way down the slopes.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, that's marvelous. Skiing is good.
She's down slopes. That's very unusual.
Down slopes?
Snow ski.
She's serious. And Ross, you remember, is a fellow with a mustache. Remember Ross? He's married, has two kids, and lives where?
Fountain Valley.
Fountain Valley. Where is that?
It's right near Huntington Beach in Orange County.
Oh, yes. Over there by the ocean.
Right.
All right. Now, where were we here? He won the first game and has $500 and missed the big money. So we're starting with round one of game two. Becky, you have a choice of A or B.
I'll try A.
You'll try A. Try it. See what happens. On this date in 1958... Irving Brickelmeyer became the first man ever to cross a produce worker's picket line. On this same date, Mr. Brickelmeyer became the first man ever to have a blank removed from his nose. Hardy, har, har. On this date in 1958, Irving Brickelmeyer became the first man ever to cross a produce worker's picket line. Those are the operative words. On this same date, Mr. Brickelmeyer became the first man ever to have a blank removed from his nose.
Tomato?
Tomato. All right. Anything that you'd find in a greengrocer's would be okay here.
Well, I think I'm close. I said a Brickelmeyer banana.
Banana. Very good, Bob. Very good.
Very good, but wrong.
Well, that's all right. No, you're doing the best you can. Yes, sir.
I can't see. I'm sorry. I just got blinded.
By what?
You just moved in by her teeth.
Oh, her teeth.
Get a shot of that girl's teeth.
Yeah, just get a
shot. Now, those aren't your own.
Listen. And we can get your job as doing a commercial.
Yeah, yeah?
Yes.
Okay.
Would you like that?
Start tomorrow?
Right.
Okay.
And I can have 10% of it. Whatever you write.
Of the teeth?
10% of her teeth, right. What do you have to say?
I would like at least to think that they're very soft and she has a lot of cavities in the back, but I suppose that's
not
true.
No, look at
them.
They're perfect.
Oh, fudge. Fooled her that time, didn't I? I said an entire bunch of carrots.
Entire bunch of carrots? We, on the other hand, are looking for a tomato.
Lettuce.
All right, a head of lettuce. All right.
Right.
First man ever to cross a produce worker's picket line, also be the first man ever to have a blank removed from his nose. She said tomato.
This would be very uncomfortable. A cucumber.
Cucumber. Right, especially one of those overgrown ones. All right, Bill.
This was removed from his nose and put in Carl Malden's, a head of lettuce.
A head of lettuce. It's been there ever since. All right, Marcia.
She said tomato, and I said tomato. She said lettuce, and I said cucumber. Please, no applause, Rita.
No,
I know how good I know.
All right, Ross. Ready?
I'm ready.
Let's see what we have for you. Larry said, this must be the Godfather's house.
Oh, really?
Well, yeah, there's a lady in the backyard hanging blanks on the line. Thank you. How ready you are. Larry said, this must be the Godfather's house. There's a lady in the backyard hanging blanks on the line.
Bodies.
Bodies. All right. So here we go. Any of those items associated with the Godfather, Bob, would be acceptable here.
What did he say?
Bodies.
Bodies.
Bodies. Love your artwork. Yes? What'd you say?
We'll do this very, very, very quickly. Gun belts. We'll do this
gun
very
belts. Gun belts. All right.
But they can't all be winning. Even Sophia Lorenz made a couple of bad movies.
Holsters.
Holsters. Holsters.
And
okay.
Gun belts.
Shoulder holsters, gun belts. That. Yes.
An old Italian woman's not going to be able to hang bodies on a line. At Christmas, I got to take... Right.
Now he's getting literal.
At Christmas, I got to take down the coffee pot from the top shelf. They're not going to be able to put it on. Don't tell me about Italians.
What are you...
This may sound very peculiar, but if you think back to the movie, it'll make sense to you. Horses' heads.
Horses' heads. Oh, yeah. Right. Bizarre.
I ain't got no bodies.
There we are.
Not true.
A right answer.
A correct answer, right.
God, I feel my heart. Well, even though I don't count your godfathers among my near and dear, this doesn't sound all that bad to me either. FBI agents.
I like it, Marsha.
No pleasing you.
All right. So he has two, Becky, and that means you'll have some catching up to do in round two. And now let's see what you think of this. All right. Round two coming up. Final round, final game. Ross, you're ahead. You go first.
A, please.
The trainer said, I think Rocky the Boxer is getting punchy. He even blanks with his gloves on. All right. Here we go, Ross. Trainer said, I think Rocky the Boxer is getting punchy, even blanks with his gloves on.
Makes love.
Makes love. All right, Brett.
What'd he say?
Makes a lover.
Makes a love. You do speak many tongues, too.
That's right.
I said something that may or may not give you. Makes a little whoopee.
Makes a little whoopee. There's one. He's up to three now. Yes, sir.
He eats.
With he eats with his gloves on, making it very difficult. Not necessarily a booable answer, in my judgment. Marjorie?
Yes.
Rocky
yes,
the Boxer's getting punchy, even blanks with his gloves on.
Well, I hope this is not booable either. He tinkles.
Yeah. Yeah, I told you yesterday, anything you say is going to be all right with them because you have all those
the
teeth.
The woman with the teeth said tinkle?
That's right. Yeah.
So tasteful.
Yeah. What have you got?
Oh, Marcia? It's so depressing to me. Once again, a sad comment on my life. That was the right answer. I said takes a bath.
Takes a bath.
I'm not popular, but I'm clean.
Right. Good. Now, Becky, last chance for you. Three to tie, four to win. Let's see what happens. Gary said, you know you've had too much to drink when you get home and try to take off your blanks over your head. With our Moog synthesizer theme song. All right, Becky. Gary said, you know you've had too much to drink when you get home and try to take off your blanks over your head.
Pants.
Pants. Somebody says pantyhose, will that be a match? Judge? No? Oh. What do you say?
Pantyhose won't be a match?
That's what he said.
Oh, it's close. Pants.
Oh.
I just wanted to fight for those who may follow.
All right, Brett.
Trust me, this is a true story.
Really?
I watched Bill Daly one night.
Yes.
He tried to take his shoes off
over his
head.
Oh, yes.
Right or wrong, Bill?
He's been known to take a nip or two.
Maybe as a match because it means short pants. Shorts.
Shorts. They did consider it. There, you notice there was a long pause.
I think it's going beautifully.
All right, Marjorie. You know, if you had too much to drink when you try to get home, try to take off your blanks over your head.
Your underwear.
Underwear. Now,
you must match Bill and Marcia to achieve a tie, Becky. Bill? Bill?
Jockey shorts.
Jockey shorts and socks. So that means Ross wins the game. And come on down here, Ross. Well, Becky, I'm sorry you didn't win any money, but we are going to send you some wonderful prizes. Becky Einon, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for being with us. Ross, you got another chance.
Got another shot.
Yes. Now try and do it right this time, will you? Right. Holy mackerel, Ross. Here we go. We polled the studio audience. Said write down your best answer to this. Blank tub. Remember the three fingers over the three numbers?
Right.
Yes.
Bathtub.
Bathtub. Marcia.
Oh, thanks for giving me another chance on hot tub.
Yeah. Hot tub.
Bob.
Rub-a-dub-dub, three men in a. Don't pass it, I'm telling you.
You should have kept your hand down.
So, hot tub, bathtub, and rub-a-dub-dub, three men in a tub. Yes. I'll now, you want one of those or one of your own?
I'll go with Brett's answer, bathtub.
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 All right, let's see if we have bathtub under the $100 response. Washtub is there.
There were an old group here that day.
That's right. So, it looks good for you. Don't worry about it, Ross. Everything will be all right. Let's take a look at the next one. Hot tub. All right. Last chance for bathtub. Slide the big one. Yeah, you got it.
All right. Brett gave you that response there.
Now, you've got another $500 there, Ross. That means your total take-home pay at this moment is $1,000. But step up there and give it another spin. See if you can make it $10,000 instead of $5. For $5,000.
Your luck just changed.
All right, here we go. A pocket full of blank. Pocket full of blank. All right, now, you give us the answer that matches Bill Daly.
I'm such a nervous wreck after that.
Are you quite ready?
Yes.
Good. Now, you give us the answer that matches Bill Daly. We give you $5,000, a pocket full of...
miracles.
A pocket full of miracles. That was an old Bing Crosby song, wasn't it?
No. Was it I'm old sorry, Bing... I said a pocket full of dreams. I'm
pocket
sorry.
Full of dreams.
Dang!
All right.
That's all right.
I had lint.
Pocket full of what?
Lint.
Lint. Yes, another winner.
A sure winner.
I knew it.
Now, a pocket full of dreams and a pocket full of miracles were both excellent responses. Nothing to be ashamed of. And he's got $1,000, and that's not bad. And we've got this for you. Two new players, Monty Hill and Daphne Davis. Hello. Let's get acquainted. Daphne, please tell us about yourself.
I'm a student at the University of Southern California, majoring in broadcast journalism.
Right.
And in my spare time, I love to dance and roller skate.
You do?
Yeah.
Roller skating is wonderful exercise, isn't it?
Yeah.
Where do you do it?
At the beach or at home, in the living room, anywhere.
Uh-huh. I was just watching the National Roller Skating Championships in my dressing room a little while ago.
Oh,
they,
really?
And they do everything, the pairs, they do on ice. And it was really quite grateful, graceful and beautiful. All right, Daphne, good luck to you. Monty, tell us about you.
Well, actually, I'm from Illinois, Decatur, Illinois. I'm a jack of all trades, master of none, mechanic.
You're a mechanic.
Is my basics. I'm married to a lady 20 years younger than I am. Which, you're right. I'm very nervous.
Right. Well,
I'm very nervous too, Gene, so give me a chance.
Oh, you're not nervous? Look, I touch him. I'll give him a little back rub here.
All right, good.
That'll relax you.
You married?
A couple of deep breaths. I am married, yeah. He's not as nervous as I thought he was. Daphne, you want A or B?
I'll take B.
B it is for her. Ready. Rick said, now I've seen everything. I just saw blank tap dancing.
See, A?
No, blank. I just saw blank. I've seen everything now. I just saw blank tap dancing. Rick said, now I've seen everything. I just saw blank tap dancing.
The dog.
The dog. Now, what would you say? You don't know either. You don't know either, I can tell. What do you say?
Well, number one, I don't think that that's a very good answer. I mean, my dog has taps on his paws. He dances all over the house.
Yes.
Daphne, big finish. An elephant.
An elephant. All right. When my dog prances around the kitchen floor with his long fingernails, or toenails, whatever, it sounds like tap dancing to me.
I saw well, it. Make up your mind. Is it fingernails or toenails?
Toenails.
Okay, painted. Very good.
No, they're not painted. We don't do that.
Well, now, some
of us have answers that are better than others, and then others of us, and we can't
okay,
all
just show it. We'll go right out there.
Gerald Ford.
Oh, sure. Yeah.
Oh, there are my people out there.
I like it, hon.
They boo you when you don't deserve it, and they applaud you when you don't deserve it. So
Walter Cronkite.
Walter Cronkite. Walter Cronkite. It so happens that Walter Cronkite can tap dance.
What, do you date or something? How do you know?
I know Walter, yes.
You date, do you?
Walter and I have had many dates.
Are you his dancing partner?
Yes.
I see.
Right.
I see. We won't tell anyone about that. That's not what he said.
I just saw blank tap dancing. What do you say to that?
Rover. It's got to be a match.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Yeah. Looking for a dog of an answer here.
Yeah, well, this is a dog of an answer. I said Mr. Rogers.
Rogers.
Yes, he's
I know who he is. I'm just wondering if he's ever tap danced and demonstrated something for the kids.
So.
No,
he
he's a very quiet,
he did with my dog.
He talks calmly and quietly.
He may have doctored. Never mind.
That's right. All right, Marcia, where do you?
Oh, he has mellowed. In the old days, he'd have gone for that.
Yeah, he'd have gone for that dirty joke.
I would like you to know before I do this that my mother, Jolly Joanne Wallace, who happens to think you are wonderful, call her crazy, is in the audience today.
Where?
Right there in the corner.
You kiss just as well as your daughter.
Oh, well, now listen, if she
kisses better than you do.
Oh,
Wait a minute. I just happen to know that she's been booed so many times a day, her mother is not here at all. She just did that to get an applause.
That's right.
Her mother's back in Iowa.
That's a totally strange woman.
I know this woman here. That's not her mother.
Oh. What was your answer?
What was my question?
Yeah,
the question was...
Oh, where's your mother?
I've seen everything. I just saw blank tap dancing.
I think it's a match. Boomer the dog.
Boomer the dog, yeah.
Holy mackerel.
See, Daphne, the charm of this game show is that once in a while you give those rotten answers and you come up with two matches. All right, let's carry on after we do this little message for you. Okay. You're singing, Charles.
No, he isn't.
Vocalizing? No. What is the name of your play?
My play is called Happy Ending, but it may be changed with it. But I'm really thrilled to be working with Paul Winfield, because I think he's the most...
Where are you going to open?
St. Louis. Webster Grove.
All right, well, that's going to be nifty.
I'll be there.
Are we invited to the opening?
Oh,
all expense paid trip?
Oh, of course.
Oh, all right, you heard it, friends. She has a definite commitment.
I'm busy that night.
Round trip,
thank
first
heavens.
Class tickets for me. All right, Gene Weaver, join us next time for the match game. Goodbye.
Some of our contestants will receive elegantly styled watches by Jules Jurgensen, ladies' quartz analog with rectangular case, six diamonds, mesh bracelet, plus a gents' quartz analog day date and carat clad case with matching bracelet from Jules Jurgensen. And beautiful sweepstakes carpeting from Galaxy Carpet Mills features ankle-long nylon with Scotch Guard. Galaxy sweepstakes in 10 contemporary colors. And if you notice your nails lightly, buff them to a brilliant no-polish shine with Nail Buffs, the nail treatment for the whole family, from Nail Buff by Terrace of Springfield, Massachusetts. And from across the Pacific comes Hawaiian Tropic, natural tanning lotions and oils, plus this attractive Hawaiian Tropic inflatable rack. And there's a chore boy for every chore. Plastic puffs, clean casseroles, and no-stick surfaces without scratching. Chore Boy Plastic Puffs. More scour to you. Bill Totman, production. This program is edited for broadcast.